actually never watched play coach hockey.
Let's say hi, right?
And we welcome you to the Plymouth Ice Center here in Plymouth, Minnesota, as we get ready for our final game of the day. It's Hill Murray against Wayzata in what should be a very exciting contest. The Pioneers and the Trojans, Wayzata, the host of this tournament, a pretty full house here tonight at the Plymouth Ice Center, as most of the bleachers are taking in another good 20, 30, 40 people up on the rails as well. So good crowd tonight. Pioneers looking to get back on track after they have dropped one and tied one in their last two. Lost to White Bear Lake 3-2 on the 17th of December. And then they tied St. Thomas Academy at the Catholic Cup Showcase at the Tria Rink in downtown St. Paul. Meanwhile, the Wayzata Trojans, after starting the year 0-3, are on a roll. They won 4 in a row, then a tie to Bunnell St. Margaret's and a win against St. Cloud. So they are unbeaten in 6 in a row. So we'll see what happens here tonight. Should be a very fun contest as we're officially underway. Wayzata and Hill Murray. Wayzata in those yellow uniforms moving from right to left. Hill Murray in the green and white moving from left to right. So underway as the Trojans move it down low. as that's Ben Lutke with it. And now the Pioneers come up the ice. Nick Pierre, the speedy sophomore forward, who is one of the top players already in the state, connecting now along the left side. Siemens will drop it here for his defense. Fired into the zone by Kyle Mortensen, and now played up along the wall by Jake Schneider. Right there, and dug out by the Pioneers as now it's gloved down here by Jake Schneider. He'll swing it across for his defense as they move tape to tape along the left side into the zone. Jake Keller slowing it down for Wayzata. Keller's shot sticked away by Keppel, and this one will just go out of play. First shot of the game for either team so far. And so Remington Keppel getting the start in goal for Hill Murray. Keppel has been good so far and looked really good against St. Thomas Academy despite that 1-1 tie. Only the one goal allowed for Keppel in that game. Keppel along the wall. Delayed offside there for a moment, but put into the zone by Godbout for Hill Murray. Along the Wayzata bench, finally moved up the ice. Drop pass there into the zone. Good defense from the Pioneers as they work it back up to the point, but not out. Good keep along the wall. Funny carom off the sideboards, and Godbout will take a hold of it and move it up out of the zone for Hill Murray. Back into their end. Keppel wanted an icing, but won't get it. Hill Murray defense will scoop it up and move it back up the boards. Along the wall, taken a hold of now by Godbout, who's had possession of the puck a lot here early on for the Pioneers. Now Seamus Reagan up the boards for Hill Murray. Lost it there for a moment. Reagan getting tied up and now played up along the wall. This one into the netting, out of play with about 15:01 to go here in the first. Hill Murray and Wayzata, you're watching the Tradition at the PIC tournament presented by Tradition Companies, a proud partner of MNHockey.tv. Interested in learning more about all the great things that Tradition Companies can do for you? Go to traditioncompanies.com. Keppel making the glove save there as this one will go off the boards. Pioneers pick it up below the goal line. Jared Jensen finds his man Owen Quast up the boards. Now Jensen and Quast working there for Hill Murray. High off the glass and gathered in here by Leo Gruba. Back below the boards now, or behind the net rather. Up along the boards, Owen Quast. Now off the stick there of Luke House. It'll go back into Hill Murray territory. Gruba trying to find Quast again. And Hill Murray having problems breaking out here as this will go for an icing against the Pioneers. 14:13 to go in the period. So back down to Wayzata offensive territory. Remington Keppel will get ready for the faceoff, which will be to his left. Off the draw, Trojans win it as they backhand it into the corner now. Ben Lutke after it. Lutke working along the boards and getting it down low now for Siemens. Siemens tied up along the wall and now gathered in by Hill Murray. Charlie Strobel, speedy forward up to Nick Pierre, trying to go in the slot here as this one will skip off the tape and move back for Wayzata. Here they come, nice drop pass in the slot and a nice diving effort from the Hill Murray defenseman there. Nick Pierre will pick it up along the wall and exit it up ahead for Fleischacker. Pierre with the shot, that one sails over the top here as it'll be kept in at the line by Henry Eichen. Back below the goal line now. Good physical pressure here from Hill Murray. Strobel with it there for the Pioneers and now moved out through center by the Trojans. Reagan head starting the entry there for the Pioneers. Here come the Trojans. Nice save by Keppel. Rebound, and Keppel turns that one aside as well as Pierre will scoot it up ahead for the rest of his Hill Murray teammates. Flipped into the zone, so the Pioneers will get a change. And no icing here as we'll continue play. Just under 13 minutes to play, first period. Icing here against the Trojans. We'll go back down to the other end. 12:50 to go in the first period between Hill Murray and Wayzata. Two shots for Wayzata, none for Hill Murray here in the early going. Those are the shots on goal, of course. Wayzata off the draw. That's Carson Peters. Can't get it out. Good keep at the line. Now down low. Wayzata trying to get this one out. Stuck up along the wall for Jake Schneider. Flipped up now through center, where it's off the skate there of Reagan. Now backhanded off the boards right in front of our ice mic. This one will go up in the air. And a nice little maneuver there. And that puck's loose in front of the net. Still whacking away. And the net came off its moorings. And so we get the stoppage. But not before a chance there for Hill Murray. 12:15 to go in the period. That was their first really good opportunity of the game. So off the draw, this one back behind the Wayzata goal as they look to flip it up, played by a high stick, so Hill Murray will take it in. That one, Max Zupfer, and now fired in as it'll be cut off here by Grant Bonello, the starter for the Wayzata Trojans tonight, number 30, the senior goaltender. Now gathered in on the tape, here's Lewis across the line, shot there right into the glove of Remington Keppel for the whistle. 11:45 to go in the period. Good look at Remington Keppel there in those nice pads that have the Hill Murray logo right in the middle. Gotta say, those are some of the best pads in the state, up there with Lott and Hoag of Edina, who also has really good pads. A lot of goalies here at the high school level have some nice looking pads as we begin back the other way. Hill Murray into the zone. Jared Jensen takes a hit up along the wall. In there as well was Kyle Mortensen for the Trojans. Now up along the wall. Thrown near the front. Wayzata trying to get it out. Jake Keller flips it up ahead. And now flung off the glass there. And it will be an icing again here. This time against Hill Murray. 11:17 to go here in the first period. A lot of icings in the early going between these two teams. Shots on goal are 3-1 so far in favor of Wayzata. And they will have an offensive zone faceoff to work with here. Off the draw, kept in at the point here by the Trojans as that's fired deep by Carson Peters. Whacking away now in the corner, both teams. Backhanded up, and Polotichuk will grab it for Hill Murray. Up the boards they come. Nice outlet pass connecting with Owen Quast. Jared Jensen now with it for the Pioneers. And back up to the point. Here's Fleischacker, just lost it and gave it away. And so Wayzata will come back the other way. Keppel will let this one go back behind the net and be played here for Fleischacker. Back to Polotichuk, and now the Pioneers on the breakout attempt. Got stuffed there. Nick Mountain in there as well with Polotichuk. And bumped up ahead by Fleischacker. Not out. Good keep at the line. Blocked in front. All kinds of bodies there as the Pioneers will finally move it out. Owen Quast. And now Polotichuk back to grab it in his own end. Polotichuk up through center. Gave it away to Peters. And Peters will go back and up the ice. Along the wall. Taken a hold of now by Joe Polotichuk. Back behind the net. Trojans grab possession. Back up to the point. This one deflects out of play with 9:56 to go, or 9:55 rather, to go in this first period. Good action between these two teams. Hill Murray ranked, I believe, number 5 on our MNHockey.tv power rankings right now. They were up at number 3 at their highest point, but rough week is keeping them down to number 5. Still very good numbers for Hill Murray. As this one will go into the corner here for Wayzata as they continue to work in their defensive end. Good job by the Pioneers here in the offensive end. Captain at the line, moved to the left wall, and back down low for Hill Murray. Max up for back to the point. Shot from that left point was blocked. And up along the wall. Taking a hold of big wrister over the top there by Hunter Lashinger. And a good opportunity for the Pioneers goes awry. Back below the goal line now. Good job by Gavin O'Connell pinning up this puck along the wall in his own end. Killing some more time here in the first 9 minutes to go. We've played about half of this first period already. Trojans finally pick it up and move it out of the ice. Joe Tomczyk sends it deep. Kempel will go out to play it. 8:48 to play in the first frame. Lashinger gave it away at center, right on the tape of Davison. Now here's a shot, and Kempel snags it up with the glove. It was probably the first good look of the game right there for Wayzata. And they'll hang on for the whistle. 8:38 to go in the period. Faceoff will be to the right here of Remington Kempel, the Hill Murray starting goalie for tonight. He's been good all season long backing this Pioneers team. Leo Grubenow plays it up the boards, and the Pioneers will exit the zone. Henry Eichen now pushed back to the corner, and this one will be a delayed offsides grabbed by the Pioneers. As they moved out, here's Nick Pierre with speed now along the right side. Pierre dishing it off, and that one bounced in on the goaltender Bonello, who had to fight it off. Now back the other way, Wayzata trying to a charge of their own here as Siemens, but they are offsides with about 8 minutes to go now in the period. Referee blowing that one dead, so faceoff will come outside the zone. This one will be just in front of the Hill Murray bench here. And it looks like Eichen's going to get tossed here for Hill Murray. And I'll have a teammate step in. Nick Pierre now just had it on the stick for a moment, but backhanded into the zone. Eichen will play it out here for Hill Murray, or Fleischacker rather. Again into the bench, 7:48 to go in the first frame. For Wayzata, the story for them is they've started slow to the year. They lost their first three games to Moorhead, Edina, Hermantown, all very close games. But then since then, they have been unbeaten in their last six, including a tie against Bunnell St. Margaret's 1-1. That was right here at the Plymouth Ice Center last Thursday. So the Trojans have been hot lately. And again, held on to for the whistle, 7:39 to go the first. But Hill Murray played a really hard-fought game against St. Thomas Academy, another team that was predicted to take a step back this year and lost. They've lost a few games, including some to Holy Family. But Hill Murray is still a very good team, and this is going to be a fun one tonight. Here come the Trojans into the zone. Keller leaves it there, and they were trying to go to the backdoor. Penalty coming up. Schneider was the intended recipient, and we're going to see if we can catch this one on replay here. It's a hook against the Pioneers, and let's see what we get here on this replay. Take a look at this one. Wayzata coming into the zone, and you see Schneider get hooked right there, and that one's going to go against Polodichuk. So there's your penalty against Hill Murray. And we will continue on. So power play here for Wayzata, and kept in just momentarily at the line by Wag. Now Wag with it as he'll swing it across. Oh, Pioneers trying to defend here with that box in front of the net. And now a nice bounce out for Hill Murray as they get it down the length of the ice. Again, a hook on Polodichuk is the call against the Pioneers. So they will have to kill off a penalty, but already 30 seconds gone for Wayzata on this power play. Up into the Hill Murray bench, and we get a stoppage here. 6:51 to go in the first. Coming up for these teams in the rest of the tournament, Hill Murray will play Kloakaska-Carlton tomorrow, and then they will play STMA, St. Michael Albertville, on Saturday. Wayzata will play STMA on tomorrow, actually. Then they will play Blaine on Saturday. So Wayzata-Blaine going to be another good game. Tough competition here at the Tradition at the PIC tournament. back at the line now. Wayzata with a minute 14 of power play time. Up along the wall, moved down low, and held onto on the right side. Good work here by Hale Murray, not preventing any lanes. Lutke will move it down low. Lutke picks it up in that right corner. Lutke shooting, missed the net over the glove side of Keppel. And now punched out along the line and moved out of the zone. Good job by Hale Murray on the penalty kill. Look out, and a sliding player into the net. We'll stop the clock with 6:12 to go. Looks like everybody's okay, so we'll get the net situated here. We'll see where they have this faceoff. Looks like it's center ice. 44 to go on that penalty to Pelotichuk. And a faceoff will be just outside the zone. Off the draw, played into the Wayzata zone as it's gathered in here by Kyle Mortensen and up the boards. Mortensen will leave it back. Mortensen into the zone for Wayzata, circling at the top of the points and moving it to the right hash. Up again to the point, Wag, and back to Mortensen. 22 to go, now at the back door in front, and that one just slides across the crease for Keppel. Now here's a lane, and Gavin O'Connell got whacked on the stick. Here's another try from Wag into the glove of Keppel, no problem, as he makes the save. 5:38 to go in the period, and about 10 seconds to go in that penalty to Pelotichuk. Get a good look there at Remington Keppel, keeping this game scoreless here in the early going. Off the draw, and this one will be done over again here. 7 to go on the power play as Pelotichuk waits. I'll show you at the end of the first period. Off the draw, quick shot blocked in front by the Pioneers and finally scooted out of the zone by Nick Pierre. That will do it for the Wayzata power play as they are unable to score on it, and we remain 0-0. Across the line, Hale Murray trying to work with it here again as Eichen plays it. And now Hale Murray will gather it again right at the circle. Here's Charlie Strobel into the zone on the left side. Strobel slowing it down as he holds on to it. Getting tied up, good work by the Wayzata defense there, slowing things down. And now bumped out of the zone. Eichen trying to get it out through center, cleared down. Pelotichuk will let this one, Keppel will let this one go back behind the net as the Pioneers look to move out. Across the line, Strobel again with it, leaves it for Pierre, who had it knocked off his tape, and now the Trojans come charging the other way. Here's Lewis in front. Keppel makes the save. A rebound goes to the point. Nice save there by Keppel, and he makes another one there on the back door as well. Lewis and moving it back up to the point. Rister there, blocked through the traffic, and still held on to by Lewis as he gets it off. 4:16 to go in the period, slid across to the point. Tomczyk shot, rebound, or blocked rather, as Pierre took a bump off the wall, and Strobel will play it out into the neutral ice. Quickly fired right back down into the zone. 4:02 to go in the first. Big hit along the corner. Ben Lutke up to the point. Big drive, missed the net wide of Keppel on the left side. And Ness will play it in the corner for Wayzata as they continue to work down low. Keppel sliding from post to post, getting ready for that next opportunity, and now Nick Pierre will work it out of the zone. Nice dish in front. Here's a breakaway. Wister save, and the rebound pounced on, and we get a stoppage. Excellent feed in front there, and that was Dylan Godbout on the breakaway. See if we can try and catch this again here on the replay. So watch it one more time. This is Pierre on the right wing, and then he flips it up through center. Nice save on Godbout there, so nice chance. So 3:30 to go in the first, still scoreless here between Wayzata and Hale Murray. Now along the line, into the zone in front, and Keppel makes a great glove stop. That one is worth checking out on replay again too, as Remington Keppel now has to make a big save. We're moving quickly. Don't have really time to work this replay here as the officials want to keep things moving. Chopped that at the wall by the Pioneers as Tristan Tabakul is out on the ice for the first time tonight. Up top now. Hold on to nice feed at the right side. They score! It bounced off a man in front, and the Pioneers get a lucky bounce, and they make it 1-0.
Got 8-14-2.
So watch this on the replay here, at least for the moment. Let's see what we get here. Keep an eye on 14 at the point. That's Fleischacker. Gets it, bounces it. And a nice little bounce there for the Pioneers as they strike to make it 1-0. So here we go, Pioneers. That goal coming from Tristan Tabakul. And the primary assist to Matthew Fleischacker, secondary assist to Jared Jensen. So Pioneers have the early 1-0 lead here. Flipped up out through center, gathered in and fired into the corner by Leo Gruba. This will be Garrett Bonello back to play it for Wayzata. Trojans trying to even things up here after giving up that goal. As Sil Murray will play it. Gruba with a nice pass up on the left side. Nice maneuver. Backhanded by Quast toward the slot area. Didn't work out though for him. Stapled along the boards, and now Wag will go back to get it. Hill Murray, though, still with possession. Great job in the corner. Luke House will send it back below the goal line. Physical pressure as Jared Jensen got bumped up there. Now kept in at the line and moved back around to the other side by House. Under two to play in the period as Wayzata takes a hold of it and moves it up. Big hit there along the wall. Tape to tape it goes for House. Leaves it. Big shot from Strobel. That one was blocked in front by the Trojans. And now back in behind the Wayzata net, thrown towards the goal mouth. And Pierre will pick it up on the right side. Here's Nick Pierre back to the point. Reagan with a shot. Redirected. They score. It's 2-0 as the shot in front, or the shot from the point rather, got redirected. That was Seamus Reagan's shot that found its way to the back of the nets, and let's see if we can take a look at this one here on replay.
27-26.
Watch this again, redirected perfectly. That is gonna be Charlie Strobel that gets the goal for Hill Murray. So already the Pioneers with a 2-0 lead in this first. Wayzata now down by two, trying to get this puck out here with a minute and 13 seconds to go in this first frame. Kept in at the line by Reagan. He'll swing it across now as the Pioneers are trying to strike here again. 1 minute now to play in the period as Wayzata takes a hold of it up through center. Nice hit off the puck there by Nate Hardy. And a delayed offside, so Wayzata will have to scatter and regroup. Here's Begley into the corner. And thrown towards the goal mouth again and fought off by Bonello. That one came a little bit too close for comfort. Now Luke Key the other way. Sticked away by Remington Keppel. And Wayzata one last chance to try and make something happen here in this first period. Unable to be kept at the line, so it's played by Carson Peters. High off the glass, gathered in by Fleischacker behind the net, and still dish it off. Now up through center come the Pioneers. One last stint to end this period at the line. Strobel right there. Pelotichuk, good save from Bonello. And 2 seconds and one. That will do it for the first period of play as it's Hill Murray with a couple of late goals in the period. And they lead it 2-0 over the Wayzata Trojans. Goals in that period from Hill Murray. That's Tristan Tabakul and Looks like as well Charlie Strobel on the second goal. Sounds like we're going to have some intermission entertainment here, and our cameraman David Hillen is getting ready to show something very unique going on in the corner. Hard to see with those big heads in the way, but we'll see what we can do. So we'll keep it right here for now. It's Hill Murray 2, Wayzata nothing. You're watching MNHockey.tv's coverage of the Tradition at the PIC tournament.
Too heavy? Try it.
I got it.
It up. Two, three. Good. Looks great.
Wow. This looks amazing. Can I help you make a few?
Sure.
You sure?
Uh-huh.
Hi, I'm Derek. Nice to meet you. So how long have you been doing this?
2 years.
2 years. So you're an expert.
Yes.
Can you do one with my name?
Sure.
D-E-R-E-K?
D-R-E-K?
D-E-R-E-K.
D-E-R-E-K?
Yes.
Okay.
What's the ultimate dream for your business?
I really wish I had more bracelets to make every single day.
What do you do with the money?
We have this hunger project that I give back to the kids that don't have enough money to buy food.
So the more bracelets you make, the more money you raise, and then the more kids you can help out. How long have you had this dream?
10 years.
So you're 6 years old and you had the dream for 10 years. That's pretty good. That's someone that knows what they want to do in life.
Yeah.
Okay, now, what do you think about this?
Ooh. Yeah.
Pretty good?
Yep.
he's got the logo right in the middle. It's pretty freaking sexy. Lott and Hogue of Edina. Maybe the best pads in the state up here with Remington Keppel. Welcome back to the Plymouth Ice Center here in Plymouth, Minnesota. It's the Hill Murray Pioneers with a 2-0 lead over the Wayzata Trojans after the first period of play. A couple of goals late in the period for Hill Murray. And Tristan Tabakul had the first one, and Charlie Strobel had the second one for Hill Murray. And again, those are both late, coming with less than 5 minutes to play in the period. So the Pioneers looking to add more here as we begin this period right off the draw. And stoppage here as our producer now taking over, Tanner Lalek, gets a quick opportunity to start and stop the clock. Faceoff will be to the left of Remington Keppel here. Belodichuk will move it back below the goal line, and a long stretch pass up for Strobel. This will not be an icing, and it's played to the corner dangerously as Strobel finds Pierre. Just hops off the stick of Belodichuk, and Belodichuk will fire it down low below the goal line here. Garrett Bonello, the starter for Wayzata, playing it up the boards. And nice physical play here by both of these teams as Ben Lutke tries to move it in. Now Jack Siemens will play it out. Belodichuk chasing after it as he has it behind the net. Now up the boards, Fleischacker. And nice touch pass there from the Pioneers as House has it offsides with 16:10 to go in the period. Shots on goal in the early going here are 9-7 in favor of Wayzata, but they trail 2-0. Faceoff just outside the Pioneers' offensive zone. And off the draw, it'll be taken in here by Godbout. Godbout in the corner for Hill Murray as he's pressed up along the wall. And Hill Murray is technically listed as the home team despite this being at Wayzata's rink. Here's O'Connell slowing it down. O'Connell shoots, saved by Keppel as he fought it off on the upper body. At the point, swung across now. Here's Peters back down low as O'Connell will swing it to the other side. Now O'Connell with it on the tape behind the net, trying to look for a man in front, turns around and fires it off a Hill Murray defender. Now at the wall again as Wayzata plays catch on that left side. Sliding down for Keppel, who steers it aside. Into the corner now, gathered in by O'Connell. He's had the puck a lot here in the offensive zone. Now banked up to the point. Peters' shot there was blocked. Follow-up try and a big windup also hits off a body. That one went off of Seamus Reagan for Hill Murray. And a penalty coming up here. This one will be against, let's see, it's a slash, I think, against Hill Murray. And that is what, actually no, this one's going to be against Wayzata. Looks like it was Gavin O'Connell that will go to the box. So off the draw, Hill Murray on the power play now, already up 2-0 as they swing it across. Here's Fleischacker. He'll move it down low and get his return feed along the left hash. Fleischacker with it down low. In front, and that one sails off the top. Now Pierre will swing it back up to the point. Belodichuk and Pierre playing catch, but the Trojans will clear it down as it's sticked away by Keppel. Now Keppel will just drop it back here. Minute 30 on the Hill Murray power play. Belodichuk and Pierre into the zone. Here's Nick Pierre, the sophomore forward for Hill Murray. Pierre swings it across. Fleischacker, Belodichuk misses wide. And Fleischacker just couldn't pull in the rebound as well. Finally flung out of there by Wayzata. as they will get it down. A Remington couple way out to play this one along the line, finding Charlie Strobel. Strobel shot, missed the net high over the glass as it rides right in to the, or near the home arena bench, not in it, as it stayed in play. Now down low, Polotichuk taking a hold of it. The defenseman for Hill Murray tied up along the circle and bumped out of there by Hill Murray. Here they come across the line, but offsides as Polotichuk just couldn't hang up. 13:36 to go in the period and 35 on the penalty. Face off just outside the Wayzata zone here. As off the draw, here we go. Tie up in the circle. A couple players go down, but Hill Murray able to bounce it into the zone. Back behind the goal line. Picked up by Wayzata, and they'll scoop it out of the zone and get it down for Remington Keppel once again. 16 to go in the Wayzata power play. The Wayzata penalty kill. Hill Murray power play as they look to move it in again. Good hustle into the corner by Godbout. Around the outside, moving it back up top for Seamus Reagan. Now Reagan gave it away, and he's got to get back right out of the box. And that one just a little bit too strong for O'Connell as he goes in, crashing into the corner. Wayzata nearly had a break there to try and cut the deficit in half, but it was a too hard of a pass there for Gavin O'Connell to gather in. Faceoff will be at center ice here, and Murray up 2-0 on goals from Tristan Tabakul and Charlie Strobel. Those are your two goal scorers up to this point for the Pioneers. Now here's Schneider, dumps it off, Rister into the glove of Remington Keppel once again. That is the 11th shot on goal for the Pioneers so far today. Off the draw, Rister again, that skids wide of Remington Keppel. And down low into the corner, it will go. Bounces up and sneaks past Polotichuk. Or rather, looked like that was Nick Mountain. But this will be icing against Hill Murray. Good hustle from Mountain to try and get there, but unable to get there in time. So back down to the other end. Trojans have it now, or had it there for a moment off the draw, but Hill Murray takes a hold of it. Out of the zone it will come as Jensen moves it up ahead into the corner and down low as Wayzata will play it here up the boards. Wag trying to get it out. That one skids wide of Garrett Bonello. Chopped at along the wall and played out. Here come the Trojans into the zone. O'Connell dishes it off. Save by Keppel. Nice job fighting that one off with that right pad. Into the corner now, down low. Trojans cycle it back and up to the point. Big shot there to flex, and Keppel fought it off again. That one coming off the stick of Wag, who comes in to pinch in and keep this puck in the zone. Now the Pioneers with it, moving it up through center. 11:44 to go in the period. Long stretch ice pass complete. Here come the Trojans. Big Rister and a good job by Polotichuk getting back and preventing Hayden Davison with the scoring chance. Now Wag off the stick and up the boards. Hill Murray will come out of the zone. Wag on the backhand turned it over as that was Fleischacker. And now back the other way. It could be a 3-on-1. Here's the chance. The big Rister, and Keppel just got a piece of it. Coming off the stick of Davidson again, who's been all over the ice this shift. Now the Pioneers move it up the boards, and Wag will send it down low and up for Polotichuk. Polotichuk drops it off, just missed intended recipient, Max Zupfer for Hill Murray. Now the Pioneers hang on to it along the far boards. Nate Hardy moving it down low and back up to the point. Fleischacker and Polotichuk. Polotichuk shoots, loads it up, rebound, and that one chopped at a little bit too high from Lashinger. And now up through center it will come. Hayden Davison firing this one into the corner as it's played off the wall. 10:27 to go in this second stanza. And blown down. And let's see, offsides is the call. So we'll get a stoppage here, 10:22 to go in the period. Let's take a look at this one on replay. And we're seeing this was the previous shot that went over the top. Nice job by our producer, Tanner Lalick, who they call the Tan Dog, from what I hear. Flipping that, and a good look at that scoring chance again for Wayzata. Unable to convert, though. And now glove down at the line. Played back into the zone by Wayzata. Pressure in the corner here as Reagan is pinned up along the wall. Thrown near the front of the goal as Wayzata works at it in the corner. Kimlinger there for Wayzata. And Reagan will go and hustle after it here for the Pioneers. Reagan lays a man out. Nice hit by Seamus Reagan. Some of the Wayzata fans wanted a call there, but they won't get one. Into the corner now. Ben Lukey trying to move it back to the point. Intercepted by the Pioneers. Strobel trying to play it out. Can't do so as it's gloved down at the line. Bumped off here for Axel Begley. And a nice hit at center. Boy, Ben Lukey just laying down the hammer here at center ice. And now played back by Mortensen. He'll drop it off in the slot. Right there in front, and it slides right across the crease. And Mortensen will chop at it and get it back up to the point. Desperate for a change. And now swung around to the far side for Tucker Ness. Ness with the shot sticked away by Keppel. Into the corner now again. And great work by Wayzata at the point. Dishes off. Here's the shot from Ness. Blocked down. Reagan on his knees to try and move it up for Strobel. But kept in by Wayzata as they continue to work away here. And they will clear it down the length of the ice. Great job as the Wayzata fan salutes. Wayzata had a lot of chances there in the offensive zone. They actually lead the shots on goal margin 14-8 right now. But the score remains in favor of the Hill Murray Pioneers here, 2-0. Offensive zone draw for Wayzata. And it looks like Tristan Tabakul will be the new faceoff man for the Pioneers. Down low as they win the draw and get it out of the zone. This one will go back into the corner. Great hustle by Tabakul into the corner. Now back around the other way. Zupfer and Tabakul working. Right there in the slots, and that one missed the net as it's picked up along the far side boards by Sauer. And now the Pioneers will come out with it. House fires it deep. 8:14 to go in the second frame. Banked off the glass and fired right back in the zone off the glove there of the Hill Murray player. Wayzata and Hill Murray battling it out here at the Tradition at the PIC tournament. And hang on, we got a couple extra jabs here. That was Max Zupfer and Drew Getz for their teams. It doesn't look like we're going to have any extra penalties assessed, but get the stoppage here. 7:59 to go. Still 2-0 in favor of Hill Murray. Faceoff just outside the Wayzata zone here as we resume activity. Polodichuk gave it away at center, and now the Trojans come into the zone. Nice drop pass there, and a penalty coming up. Big collision. This one's going to go against the Pioneers, and so Wayzata will have it and get that extra attacker out on the ice. Played up on the left wing side into the zone. Lewis fires it down low, and that will be touched finally for the whistle. So the Trojans going to go on the power play here in a chance to potentially cut this deficit down to 2-1.
We have a 5-minute major for head contact.
So head contact was the call there on the penalty, and it's actually going to be a five-minute major against the Pioneers. So 5 minutes of power play time. Pelotichuk to the box again. This is his second trip there. And Wayzata, lots of time to work with here. 5 minutes, and again, keep in mind with major penalties that they last for the full time. They do not go away with a goal. So lots of time for Wayzata. Here's Wag, and so dish it off on the left side. Trojans with a chance to really alter the flow of this game here on this power play. Wag will swing it across now for Mortensen, who goes down low, but the Pioneers trying to get it out, and they do so. Nice job getting it down the length of the ice with 7:06 to go here in the period. 4:30 to go of power play time. Nick Pierre working along the wall. Big hit thrown by Charlie Strobel, who's doing a really good job on the forecheck here on this penalty kill. Now a long pass connects on the left side. Here come the Trojans into the zone. Drop pass in the slot, saved by Keppel. And a rebound taken a hold of in the corner by Schneider. Now Schneider holding on to it on the left side, moves it down low for Siemens. Siemens hanging on to it, back down low for Schneider in the slot. Just had a roll off the tape as Pierre got down, taken down, and this is going to be a penalty against the Pioneers as it's a trip, and we'll see what we get here. This is going to alter the 5 minute, but Strobel going to the box. We're going to have coincidental minors, so that will keep
2 minutes trip, 2 minutes slash, nothing new.
2 minutes for tripping, 2 minutes for slashing, and nothing going up on the board, so you can just leave that as is. We'll play 5-on-4 here as, or yeah, we'll still have the 5-on-4 power play for Wayzata. So 3:48 to go on that penalty. And coincidental minors assessed to both teams. And it looks like indeed we will have 5-on-4. Wayzata with 5, Hill Murray with 4. Of course, Pelotichuk, the head contact major penalty that was assessed. And the Wayzata faithful starting to hear it. Packed house here at the Plymouth Ice Center tonight. There are not many open seats remaining. Lots of people on the rails here to check out this great game between Wayzata and Hill Murray. Along the wall now, fired into the zone off the stick of Carson Peters, the defenseman. Keppel will play it up the boards, and it hops just off the stick of Tucker Ness. And good job on the forecheck here by the Pioneers. That's Henry Eichen up the boards now. Hill Murray getting it out of the zone, killing some more time as they've killed off about 2 minutes here of this penalty kill. And Tucker Ness will play it behind the goal. 3:05 to go on the power play for Wayzata. 5 minute major assessed to Pelotichuk for Hill Murray for head contact. Held at the point, swung over. Here's Peters. We'll move it to the circle. Now back up, and it rolls off the tape, so Peters will have to grab it here at the line. Delayed off sides, they tag up and grab it here for Fleischacker. Sails off the glass, good keep at the line. Wayzata with it down low. Good work here in the corners. They move it back up to the point and swung across. Here's Ness, gets it back. Ness with the shot, scores! Tucker Ness! And this is a one goal game as Wayzata strikes to make it 2-1. Take a look at it here on the replay. Shot from Tucker Ness. He'll keep an eye on him right at the top of the point there. And the shot, he'll get it back, loads up the wrister, and fires it in on goal to make it a 2-1 game. Just make sure you hit the one before you go to the replay next time. Other than that, it was good. So Tucker Ness getting the goal. That assist will go to, looks like, Dylan Lewis there. So 2-1 now in favor of Hill Murray after the power play goal for Wayzata. And they still have another 2:13 to work with here. Here's Wag across the line with some space. Wag shoots, saved by Keppel, who makes the stop with 2:05 to go on the power play. And 17-9 are the shots. Wayzata has been dominating this game, but they are not getting much past Remington Keppel. Just the one goal from the power play just a moment ago. Now, Mortensen will swing it around to the point. Mortensen getting his return feed and back. As Wag will move it over on the left side. Trojans still buzzing here in the offensive zone. Down low it'll go. Kept in at the left hash. Back to the point. Wag, one-timer, fires it high. And Mortensen pinching to keep it in along the wall. Good job from him. Now the Trojans back up top. Mortensen dishes it down low into the corner. And pinned up along the wall is Jack Kimlinger. Down low, Schneider with it. Gets it off. They work it back up to the point. Here's Wag back to Mortensen. 1:20 to go. One-timer from the point. Rebound! Keppel fought it off there on the post. He's without a stick now as the Hillmurray defense will get it to him. They drop it in front. Here's the one-timer, and it's fanned on at the far point, or the far hash, rather. Kept in. Great move at the line. Quick shot, and that one's turned aside. Keppel has got his stick back now for Hillmurray, so that's a good thing for the Pioneers. 55 left on the power play. Held on to at the top of the circle. Now Wag at the point. Wag, Mortensen, back to Wag. Now at that left circle, moves it down low. Good work here, 42 on the power play. Down low right at the doorstep. Great work in front by the Pioneers defense. That was Seamus Reagan. And he cycle it back down low again. Schneider with it. He'll move it over. Big wrister. Keppel with the save. Rebound and chopped out of there by the Pioneers as they get a big round of applause. Tristan Tabakul getting it down low. 2:55 to go in this second frame at 16 to go in the period, or power play rather. Cross the line. Here come the Trojans again. Keppel fights it off and kept in at the line. Nice desperation mode. One last chance for Wayzata on the power play as they move around the outside. Holding on to it now back up to the point. Here's Ness with the shot, loads it up, fires it off the glass, and chopped out of the zone there as now it's a two-on-one the other way. Here's Nick Pierre. He's got a man with him across. Pierre fanned on it. Great chance, and now they'll go across again as they look for Henry Eichen. Back and forth action we go. Fired into the zone now, as it will be played along the wall by Jack Siemens into the corner. Charlie Podlak taking a body here in the corner. Not much motion going on down there with 2 minutes to play. This one sailed up top and fired back around by the Trojans. Davidson able to keep it in at the line. Now down low, Davidson's got it again as he works, or looks for a lane rather. Now Peters with the shot loose in front and cleared out of there by the Hillmurray defense. All kinds of pressure there. This one gonna be an icing against the Trojans. And so back down to their end. This intensity really has picked up a notch here in this second period. 2-1 your score. Wayzata and Hillmurray, 1:29 to go in the period. 20-9 are the shots in favor of Wayzata, although they do trail in this game 2-1. Off the draw, this one played out of the zone by the Pioneers. Dylan Godbout with speed into the zone. Godbout on the backhand, trying to find it. Nate Hardy there at the far side. Now Hardy with it in the corner as he whacks away along the boards. Hardy in the mix as well, and will be moved out of the zone. Right in front of the net there, and now to the top of the circle. Hardy will swing it around the other way. Under a minute to play now in this second period. Wayzata and Hillmurray flung way down the length of the ice. This will be an icing against Wayzata, so it'll go back down to Trojan territory. 47.8 to go in the period, and Hillmurray can add to their lead here if they can get something right off this draw. Enough time for both teams to try and strike here and make things interesting before the end of this second stanza. We'll be Jensen on the draw for Hill Murray, but he cannot win it as it will ride the rails and stay in the Trojan end. Here's Keller, and a glove came off there on Mountain, and Wayzata will fire it into the corner as Keppel comes back out to play it. Keppel off the glass and played up along the wall. Now Polodichuk couldn't get it out, and now it's speeding the other way as Nick Mountain just couldn't get there in time. 20 to go in the period as this one will go back below Keppel. Gathered in by Fleischacker. Now it'll connect. Fleischacker got some space. Fleischacker shoots over the top, follows up his own rebound back behind the goal. 5 to go in the period as Mountain gets pushed along the boards, and that will do it for a great second period here at the Plymouth Ice Center. Wayzata gets one to make things interesting here. So they cut the deficit in half, and they set up a really, really exciting third period between these two teams. So our scoring summary so far in the game, the first two goals were scored by Hill Murray, Tristan Tabakul from Fleischacker and Jensen, and then the second goal was from Charlie Strobel, assisted by Seamus Reagan, and it looks like Henry Eichen. And then for the Trojans, the only goal of the game right now is from Tucker Ness. That was a power play goal assisted by Dylan Lewis. Is where we stand right now. We're going to step aside here for our second intermission. It's Hill Murray 2, Wayzata 1. You're watching MNHockey.TV. We'll be right back for the third period.
Too heavy? Try it.
I got it.
Lift it up. 1, 2, 3. Good. Looks great. Yeah.
Wow. This looks amazing. Can I help you make a few?
Sure.
You sure?
Uh-huh.
Hi, I'm Derek. Nice to meet you. So how long have you been doing this?
2 years.
2 years. So you're an expert.
Yes.
Can you do one with my name?
Sure.
D-E-R-E-K?
D-R-E-K.
D-E-R-E-K.
D-E-R-E-K?
Yes.
Okay.
What's the ultimate dream for your business?
I really wish I had more bracelets to make every single day.
What do you do with the money?
We have this hunger project, okay, that I give back to the kids that don't have enough money to buy food.
So the more bracelets you make, the more money you raise, and then the more kids you can help out. How long have you had this dream?
10 years.
So you're 6 years old and you had the dream for 10 years. That's pretty good. That's someone that knows what they want to do in life. Okay, now, what do you think about this?
Ooh.
Pretty good?
Yep.
Okay.
Break your heart to see what we pull out of here every day.
You guys need some help?
No, sure. Yeah.
JJ, what?
What's up, man?
How's it going?
Sure. Check it out,
man.
What are you guys doing out here?
We're just doing the right thing.
What's the dream?
My dream is for people to think twice before they throw something out.
I appreciate you having me out.
You can swing a mean net, man.
This looks amazing.
We have this hunger project, okay, that I give back to the kids to buy food.
So the more bracelets you make, the more money you raise, and then the more kids you can help out.
Too heavy? Try it.
I got it.
Lift it up. 1, 2, 3. Good. Looks great.
Yeah.
Wow. This looks amazing. Can I help you make a few?
Sure.
You sure?
Uh-huh.
Hi, I'm Derek. Nice to meet you. So how long have you been doing this?
2 years.
2 years. So you're an expert.
Yes.
Can you do one with my name?
Sure.
D-E-R-E-K?
D-R-E-K?
D-E-R-E-K.
D-E-R-E-K?
Yes.
Okay.
What's the ultimate dream for your business?
I really wish I had more bracelets to make every single day.
What do you do with the money?
We have this hunger project, okay, that I give back to the kids that don't have enough money to buy food.
So the more bracelets you make, the more money you raise, and then the more kids you can help out. How long have you had this dream?
10 years.
So you're 6 years old and you had the dream for 10 years. That's pretty good. That's someone that knows what they want to do in life. Okay, now, what do you think about this?
Ooh, ooh, yeah.
Pretty good?
Yep.
Okay.
So welcome back to the Plymouth Ice Center here in Plymouth, Minnesota. It's Hill Murray 2 and Wayzata 1 after the second period of play as we get going for this third period. And it's going to be a fun one. Wayzata had their equalizer, or their goal to cut it in half, scored by Ness. That would be, of course, Tucker Ness, the defenseman, the junior defenseman for the Wayzata Trojans. That was a power play goal. Hill Murray led it 2-0 after one, and now Wayzata is back within one here as we begin this third period of play. So going to be a fun one. Wayzata will be moving from right to left here in those bright yellow jerseys, and Hill Murray will be moving from left to right in their white and green jerseys. So here we go, third period. We're bound to have an exciting finish here at the Plymouth Ice Center. 2-1 is the score. So right off the draw, Wayzata will play this one up but not out as it's kept in by Fleischacker. Now in the slot, tangled up there and played up the wall. Now here come the Trojans into the zone. Kimlinger will move it down low. Big hit along the wall as the pressure was applied there from Jack Siemens. And now out through center, it will go off the tape of Kimlinger. And now Wayzata gave it away. Here's a chance in front. Good job on the block. Pierre chops at it, but picked up by Hill Murray's Dylan Godbout. Into the corner now. Right out in front. Pierre had it slide off the tape. Now continuing to whack away back behind the net. Into the corner now. Gathered in by the Pioneers. At the line, save there, rebound, still loose, and Godbout goes dragging with it into the corner here for the Pioneers. Now Godbout trying to get it out, can't do so. Or Godbout rather trying to keep it in, can't do so, as Keppel will go back to play it for Fleischacker. Now here's Pelotichuk, who's sat in the box for 7 minutes today. A 2 minute minor and a 5 minute major. Pierre will come off the ice for Hill Murray, and Wayzata will play it up the boards. Now out through center they go. Schneider rolling around in front, and big hit there back behind the goal line. Pelotichuk swings it up on the left side as the Pioneers will fire it deep. Out to cut it off is Garrett Bonello. Off a tape now and played out through center as this one connects along the side. Here comes Davison, shoots, saved by Keppel, and turned aside into the corner as Wayzata still has possession. Good job here as O'Connell will bank it back. Now this one goes off the wickets. It'll be an icing call, or no, it will not be an icing call against Wayzata. Looked like actually a delayed offsides is what the official is holding his arm up there for, as Hill Murray will play it at neutral ice, batted down on the stick. Trojans trying to move it out as they do so. O'Connell now up ahead. Thrown towards the goal, but that one missed well wide of Keppel as it rides the rail. Back into Hill Murray territory as they exit, and now it'll be flipped into the bench out of play. So stoppage with 14:20 to go in period three. Taking a look at these teams and what they've got on the docket for tomorrow. Hill Murray will take on Cloquet Esko Carlton at 5 o'clock. And Wayzata will battle St. Michael Albertville at 2:30. That'll be right here at the Plymouth Ice Center. Here's a try down below the goal line. Keppel standing his ground. Now at the point, here's the shot from Ness, the only goal scorer for Wayzata so far. Now the Pioneers continue to work away with it here. Pelotichuk trying to shove it up the wall, and that one's out of play for the stoppage. 13:57 to go here in the third. Camera operator David Hillen hanging in there. It's been a long day for us. And Going to be another long day tomorrow as we'll start things out at 12 o'clock here. Creighton, Durham Hall, and Blaine, two of the top teams in the AA boys, so should be a fun matchup there. In the meantime, up along the wall as Omri chops at it right in front of the bench. And Godbout pinning up a man. Now Kimlinger right into the zone for the Trojans. And up along the right wing, here's Pierre throwing it towards Polodichuk as he scrambles to pick it up. Polodichuk back to Pierre and swings it out with one hand on a stick. Pass just missed Godbout. And Hag tries to move it up. Or Wag, rather. And out into the zone comes Lutke, slowing it down. Lutke, nice moves. Trying to cut inside on Remington Keppel there. It didn't work out. Now Strobel flips it up in the air. And this one will sneak by. Here's Nick Pierre on a breakaway. Nice move, and it's denied. What a stop from the goaltender, Garrett Pinello. We'll have to take a look at this one on replay for sure. And let's watch this one. Oh, actually, that's the wrong clip. We'll pause it and reset it here for you. We'll go back and take a look at that one at a later time, but that was an excellent stop from Pierre. We'll have that one ready and queued up for you at the next whistle that we get. 12:57 to go in the period, but a great stop from Bonello, keeping this thing at 2-1.
Set the time back to 13:01, please.
We're going to reset the time here to 13:01 on the clock. Make sure they get everything squared away here. And right off the draw. Here's a shot in that one, missed the net. That was just off the tape of Nate Hardy. Good opportunity from him. And now played out through center. Here's Mortensen up along the wall. Big hit applied there from Axel Begley. Wayzata into the zone in front. Keppel rebound. Another stop by Remington Keppel, who made a fantastic save twice. Keeping Hill Murray in front here, 2-1. This one will go off the boards and back for Begley. Up the wall now. Pioneers right out of the zone, trying to get something going here in the offensive zone. Stuck with it though at neutral ice are the Trojans. Up off the glass and Hill Murray will take control. Long stretch ice pass. This will be an icing against the Pioneers. So back down the other way. Let's go back now and take a look at that breakaway from Nick Pierre that we were talking about earlier. So you see Pierre right here takes a hold of it. Excellent job by David Hillen on camera getting that up close shot and a nice stop from Bonello to keep this game at 2-1. Now down low it'll go into the corner here for Leo Gruba off the iron as it's played back to the point. Ness, or rather Peters, swings it across and now back up top for Peters. Peters shot through traffic, rebound, it's loose, they score! Buried in front by Hayden Davidson, and it's a tie game, 2-2. We'll get a look at this one on replay again.
Two from 21 and 25.
Check this out. The shot there, the big rebound, and buried in front. And the Trojans have tied the game at 2. So 11:46 to go, and we've got a tie game here at the Plymouth Ice Center. That one was buried right in front there by the Trojans to get the goal. And so here come the Pioneers now at center. Polodichuk had it go off the stick and taken into the zone now by Wayzata. They score two unanswered and a wind up there. Not much on the shot from Jack Kimlinger at the far side now held in at the point. Here's Tomczyk moving it down low. And forced up along the wall. Pioneers finally moving it out, at least for a moment. Kept in, one-timer, Keppel save, rebound in the slot, and now moved over to the right point. Big wrister there, sails over the glove of Keppel. And Wayzata pressing hard here to get this game even as it's finally moved out of there by the Pioneers. 10:45 to go in the third period of a tie game, 2-2. Seamus Reagan jump starting this play here for Hill Murray as they move up through center now. Up ahead, poked into the zone by Tabakul. Now Wayzata moving it out. Here they come along the line. Reagan can't get it out. He's forced to defend. They hit up along the wall as O'Connell went hard into the boards. Pioneers now move it out. Back down into the corner here for Tristan Tabakul. Up to the point, Reagan swings it across. Big shot there off some bodies in front, but didn't get through the traffic as it'll be Carson Peters storming back the other way. Peters onside, they get it off. Here's the shot from Schneider, and a nice stop from Remington Keppel, who made the save. Keppel has let up the last two goals, but we'll watch it on replay here in just a second. Good job at the line, and better stop from Remington Keppel. Back underway, 9:49 to go in the third period. Here's a chance in front, backhanded there and broken up on the attempt as Hill Murray will come back the other way. Out through center, and a penalty coming up here against Wayzata, and that will set up a power play here for the Hill Murray Pioneers, who need something to go their way, and we'll see what they can do here on this power play chance. Trip on Wayzata's Tucker Ness. So 2 minutes on the board here of power play time for Hill Murray. They've got two penalties listed on the board, but it's just one. So Hill Murray on the power play as they get this down the length of the ice. All kinds of problems in the box as they've got a bunch of different penalties listed, but now they've got it figured out. Here's a chance in front, man taken down. Wayzata will gather the rebound as Joe Tomczyk has it. Now back down low. Pioneers working as it's forced up along the wall. Good pressure on the boards from Tomczyk. Below the goal line, Godbout trying to find a man up at the point, but this one will go down for Remington Keppel, who will usher it for Polodichuk. 1:10 to go on the Hill Murray power play time now. Fired into the zone and played at the wall. Top of the circle now, down low as the Pioneers possess it. Minute to go on the power play. Polodichuk at the point. Polodichuk dishes off, top of the circle. Polodichuk now at the point. Shoots through traffic, save, rebound. Still loose, finally bumped back to the point, but not out. Polodichuk dishes off to his man on the right side. That's Pierre. Back to Polodichuk. Now Polodichuk in the slot. Godbout off the iron. No! The officials say no as it went right off the crossbar. Hill Murray still with 28 to go on the power play. Now Polodichuk holding it, moving it. Pierre save, and the rebound does not pop out. Great job by Garrett Bonello, holding down the fort here for Wayzata, as he's a little slow to get up, it looks like. Just stretching out those legs, getting ready for another 23 seconds of time here on this power play. This has been a phenomenal contest here tonight as get ready for Bonello to get all squared away. Face off in the offensive zone for the Pioneers as they continue to jam at it here, and now worked out of there by the Trojans. Into the zone comes Schneider, but moved out the other way by Begley. Across the line, finds his man, trying to go to somebody there. Now picked up by the Pioneers down low in front, and this will go back behind the goal line as it's cleared out of there by Wayzata. This will not be an icing as they cleared it before the penalty. So Keppel will deposit it here for a teammate. Long pass tipped up through center. Here's a wrist shot in on goal and held on to by Bonello, who gets the stoppage. This is shaping up for a fun finish here. 7:18 to go in this third and final period between these teams. It's been a great game. Hill, Murray, and Wayzata. Game four of the day. Tradition at the PIC. We'll have four more tomorrow and four on Saturday here at Plymouth. Now flung up the boards, and this one went into the Wayzata bench, so we'll get the stoppage here. We'll do the faceoff outside the Wayzata zone here. 7:10 to go in the period. Shots on goal have been dominated by Wayzata, 28-16. But right now they trail, or they are tied rather, 2-2. They did trail for most of this game. They just recently got things even. And Hill Murray took a 2-0 lead after the first, 2-1 after the second, and then the equalizer coming here in the third. Now into the zone, fired wide of Remington Keppel as it's played up ahead by Hill Murray. Into the zone they come. Bumped off the puck there was Nick Mountain, who jacks it down in the corner. Now Wayzata bumping it out of the zone as it cycled back in below the goal line by, looked like Jensen there for Hill Murray. Now a tie up at the near side red line. All kinds of bodies flying around as it will be moved back into Hill Murray territory. Now Leo Gruba up ahead, dishes it off, fired in on net and held on to wisely by Garrett Bonello, who's been busy here these past few minutes. He'll get the stoppage with 6:19 to go here in this third period of what's been a really, really good game. 28-17, the shots in favor of Wayzata. They will have to defend here in their own zone on this faceoff. Off the draw, Polodichuk dishing it back below the goal line. Right in front, they were looking for Polodichuk. That was a designed play for Hill Murray, but didn't work out. Now Hill Murray back in their zone. Fleischacker moving it up ahead here for Eichen. Eichen takes a ride up along our ice mic there, and Wayzata will go back to get it. Eichen gets tangled up here. No call, though. Pioneers with it in front. Rolling round. They score! Nick Pierre buries it in front, and Hill Murray has the lead. It's 3-2.
7-6.
We'll watch this one again on a replay as keep an eye on Nick Pierre in the slot. Works his way over to the right side where nobody finds him, and he buries it. So that gives Hill Murray a 3-2 lead. Nick Pierre on the goal. The assist coming from Henry Eichen. So 5:49 to go here. And it is a 3-2 lead for the Pioneers of Hill Murray. A lot of time, though, left to play as Keppel will dish this one up along the left side. A long pass as Hill Murray wants some more. Here's Godbout into the zone. Slamming on the brakes in front. Godbout knocked to the ice here as Wayzata will take a hold of it. Nice move there by, looked like Carson Peters for Wayzata. Delayed offsides, and now Peters will play it into the zone. Here's Peters loading up, shooting, and Keppel makes an easy glove stop with 5:15 to go in the period. Take a look at this one again here on the glove save from Keppel. No problem, really, as he pretty much read it all the way. 5:15 to go in the period of a fun game. Hill Murray led 2-0. Wayzata tied it at 2. And then Nick Pierre just scored the go-ahead goal a few moments ago to give Hill Murray the lead. Kept in at the line, but quickly exited by the Pioneers as they come up. Here's number 14, Matthew Fleischacker, throwing it towards the goal. Back behind the net now as the Pioneers work in the offensive zone. Taking out by Wayzata as they exit the zone. Some of the fans wanting a penalty there, not going to get it. Scooped out of there by Hill Murray. Good speed from Tristan Tabakel. Shoots, and that one misses the net on the big wrister. Now Wayzata playing it into the zone. Nice job from Flyshecker on the back check. And this one will go into the netting here, out of play. So 4:32 to go now. And we'll have four more games again tomorrow. Our first game of the day at 12:30, going to be a good one, or 12, between Blake and, or Blaine rather, and Creighton-Darham Hall. And Raiders and Bengals both in our top 10 of our latest MNHockey.tv power rankings. They're going to go toe-to-toe. Big test for the Raiders, who have won 7 in a row entering tomorrow's game. Now at the line, Wayzata trying to take it as they move into the zone. Here's Davidson, who's got a goal for Wayzata. That was the equalizer earlier in this period. Now a scrum in the corner. Davidson trying to work it back up to the point, but this one goes into the netting out of play. So the puck will come. The faceoff will just be outside the zone here. 3:58 remaining. STMA and Wayzata tomorrow. And Hill Murray will take on, looks like, Cloquet, Esco, Carlton. So both of these teams will be playing against teams that lost today. Cloquet, Esco, Carlton lost their game to Blaine 5-3. And STMA lost 3-0 to Blake. Here's a shot that sails over the top of the glove of Keppel. Now down low for Tomczyk. Pierre dangerously out in front and now working it free as he stumbles to the ice. Back down low goes for Kimlinger. Here's Jack Kimlinger back behind the net and moving it to the far boards. Pinching to keep it in was Carson Peters. Down low, throwing it near the goal where it's scooped up by Eichen. This one right at the side of the net as they try in front. Scores! Jack Kimlinger buries it, and Wayzata has tied it with 3:11 to go. How about that? The Pioneers gave up another one here.
16 from 19 and 20.
16 from 19 and 20, as you hear from the officials. And let's take a look at this one on replay here, if we can. We'll rewind it here in a second and see if we can go back. Here we go. Here's that play right in front, and Kimlinger buries it. So Jack Kimlinger gets the equalizer here for Wayzata with 3:11 to go in the third period. We're back even. Hill Murray into the zone. Here's a chance in front. Great save. And that rebound was covered up as well. So Siemens and Lutke getting the assists on that goal as we're under three to play. 3-3 our score here at the Plymouth Ice Center. Wayzata trying to march their way back here on Hill Murray. It's been a phenomenal contest. If you're just joining us, we'll get you caught up at the next stoppage. Here's a save, and that juicy rebound was taken a hold of by that Wayzata defense as they move up ice. Now here they come into the zone as Schneider has it. Jake Schneider forced to the corner. Back around the outside and back below the goal line in front. Taking a hold of now by the Pioneers as they will clear it out of the zone with 2:23 to go. Long pass, and that one will go for Polotichuk along the wall. Now Wayzata with a little bit of a jammed entry here as it's played out of the zone. Here they come. Tristan Tabakel, or rather Nick Mountain, into the zone. Mountain shot fanned on. Wayzata scoops up that rebound. Gave it away. Here's Mountain, and the shot turned aside. When Wayzata got to be careful on those turnovers as they try and get this one out. Now Schneider pinned up along the wall. Reagan keeps. Reagan fires and turned aside again on the pad. Under two now to play in this third period. This one thrown away up in the air and gloved down here by Begley. Now across the line, here's Owen Kwas. looking for that backdoor target. That was Jared Jensen at the other side. Now here they come up into the zone. Here's Lewis, shot there, turned aside by Keppel on that left pad. Now again, another try. Keppel had to fight it off again as Lewis is right there along the wall, 120 to go. And a 3-3 game, Wayzata and Hill Murray. Now Reagan fires it off, bad bounce for the Pioneers, but Owen Quast was right there to survey the damage. And now here's Mountain. Mountain shoots off the post. It's back behind the net. And now Wayzata will take the time to gather it here as Gardner will pick it up and move it up out of the zone. Boy, Hill Murray nearly scoring the game winner there. Now up the boards they come. Here's Fleischacker. Godbout drops it off. Shot there from Polodichuk, blocked by the Trojans. 45 to go in the third period. Back around to the other side where it's played by Fleischacker. And down low into the corner by Mortensen. Mortensen trying to move it up out of the zone. And this one into the Wayzata bench. So that will stop the clock with 31.8 to go. And we'll see if we get a timeout here from either of these teams or if we'll just keep playing the rest of regulation. And we'll get a 3-minute break or so before OT. Doesn't look like we're going to have a timeout. Both teams will just keep playing here. 31.8 to go. Off the draw, Eichen can't win it. Scooped up to the line but not out as Polodichuk keeps it for the Pioneers. Back down below the goal line, Tomczyk flips it up the wall. And Hill Murray doing a good job of keeping it in. Godbout on the play. He'll swing it across. Fleischacker in front, and it just rolls wide of the crease. Now Eichen picks it up. 10 to go. Back to the point for Fleischacker. Shoots blocked. Fleischacker gets it back down low. 4 to go in the period. And Wayzata will just eat it in the corner. And that will do it for regulation time. Hill Murray and Wayzata tied at 3. And we will get a few minutes to catch our breath and get ready for overtime. The only way this game should end. It's been a great battle here at the Plymouth Ice Center. So we'll step aside for just a minute or so as Hill Murray and Wayzata get ready for overtime. Tied at 3.
This looks amazing.
We have this hunger project, okay, that I give back to the kids to buy food.
So the more bracelets you make, the more money you raise, and then the more kids you can help out.
Welcome back to the Plymouth Ice Center. Overtime coming up here between Hill Murray and Wayzata. And Hill Murray led this game 2-0.
28 minutes up.
And the Wayzata Trojans tied it at 2. And then Hill Murray got another goal to make it 3-2. But then the equalizer coming off the stick of Jack Kimlinger for the Wayzata Trojans with 3:11 to go. So that is where we stand right now between these two teams. And we'll have an 8-minute overtime. And if we don't get a goal, we'll end in a tie. So no shootout. Looks like Maple Grove and Minnetonka are in overtime right now over at the St. Louis Park Rec Center. So a couple of overtime games here on MN Hockey TV tonight. Here come the Pioneers wrapping it around. And Bonello fighting it off as he gets whacked there and takes an extra jab. And you got to be careful here if you're Hill Murray. You don't want to take any unnecessary penalties here in overtime. And so we'll see. I don't think we're going to have any extra penalties. But, again, got to keep your emotions in check here if you're both teams, really, with only 7:47 left in this game and no matter what happens. So you got to change here for both teams. Puck Her faceoff will be outside the zone. Shots on goal are 31-23 in favor of Wayzata, but we're tied here in Plymouth. Across the line, here's a big wrister from Pierre, who had the momentarily go-ahead goal for Hill Murray. Back around the outside, turnaround try by Eichen, and held on to by the Wayzata goaltender, Garrett Bonello. Bonello has stopped 21 of 24 Hill Murray shots. And 28 saves at the other end for Remington Keppel. Off the draw, one back to the point. Moved over, one timer, and that one just missed the net as it bounces off the back of the cage. And picked up by Kimlinger now, who had the tying goal a few minutes ago. Kimlinger now into the zone, and still go down into the corner. Kimlinger back behind the goal as he'll follow up to the other side. Nick Pierre right there for Hill Murray. Now the Pioneers will go back for Pelotichuk and Fleischacker, the top defense unit for Hill Murray so far tonight. Flung into the zone, 7 minutes to go in OT. We've played a minute here in overtime. Eichen in front, loose there. Backhander, now the forehand down low as it's picked up by Eichen. Moves it back to the point. Fleischacker, Pelotichuk, holding on to it now. Pelotichuk missed the net there on the wrister as Fleischacker will bump it down low again. Nice stick lift in the corner. Here's Tabakul, kicks it out in front. Nice job by the Wayzata defense as Wag was able to pin his skate in front there, and this will be an icing against Wayzata. So back down to the other end here. 6:29 to go in overtime. Again, if we don't get a goal in the next 6 minutes and 29 seconds of regulation or this overtime period, we will end in a tie. And if that is the case, Hill Murray will have tied in consecutive games. They also had a tie 1-1 against St. Thomas Academy last Saturday. Now moved out of the zone by the Trojans, but quickly picked up at center ice and bumped up the boards now by Hill Murray. Right back the other way, though, for Wayzata. Across the line, and here's Jake Keller. Keller's shot, and Keppel fights it off with the blocker. It goes up in the air back behind the net. Now Keller with it, holding on to it on the forehand down low here as Wayzata moves it back up to the point. Held on to, swung across. Here's Ness. Missed the net well wide there. Picked up on that left wing as it's back down low for Schneider, who's pinned up along the wall by Reagan. And the puck picked up in the corner again by Keller. Bumped off once more. Schneider holds it on the forehand and moves it back for Jake Keller. Up to the point now. Wayzata trying to get this down low in front, and Keppel makes the save for the whistle. 5:33 to go in this overtime period. We'll check this little chance out again here on replay. Just a little slow roller in front and held on to for the whistle. Back to the action here. Off the draw, Wayzata in the offensive zone as they win it and force it back around to the other side. Davidson trying to get there for the Trojans. Now up through center, here comes Hill Murray. Look out, oh my. That one caught a stick and came right up in the broadcast booth area. Just about a row behind, and I don't think anybody got struck. But that puck landed about three rows in front of us here at the booth. Scary situation. We had a child that was struck earlier by a puck. Luckily, it wasn't as hard as that one that came up here, but back to the action. Now flung up the boards. This one will be an icing against Wayzata, and a late whistle finally blown dead and come outside the zone here. So 5:12 to go. Face off back in Wayzata territory here. See who takes the draw for Hill Murray. It looks like it's going to be Jared Jensen, the junior forward for Hill Murray. Jensen wins it back to the point. Here's Fleischacker off a stick and into the corner here. Carson Peters pinned up behind the net. Tries to get it up the boards for Lewis. And now out through center. Dumped off on the far side as Pontiac moves it there. And now Hill Murray gains possession again. This one will go too far, and hustling on the Jets there is Wag, and this will be an icing against Hill Murray. So icings against both teams will go back down to the Hill Murray end of things here. 4:47 to go in overtime, though, of this phenomenal contest between Hill Murray and Wayzata. We knew this was going to be a good one going in, but this has lived up to all the expectation and more. Off the draw. Back below the goal line, Trojans trying to grab it as it's Ben Lutke. Lutke throwing it down low here for Siemens. And into the corner now as it's pinned up along the wall for Fleischacker. He'll grab it and move to the right side. Up the boards, nice exit by the Pioneers as they come 2-on-2. Across the line, into the zone, nice move, and it's just fired wide by the Pioneers. That was a good-looking play there from Eichen. Now Godbout trying to go back to Eichen. Eichen in front, and he rang it off the iron. Boy, Eichen nearly making it a game winner at the point. Fleischacker, one-timer off the post. Boy, Hill Murray twice. Now here's Fleischacker. Back to Polodichuk and Fleischacker again. He'll move it down low, trying to go as the referee almost took a tumble. Now Eichen up the boards. Wayzata working it out of the zone, but it's picked off. Great job stepping up, and that's a stick save there off of the shot attempt there from Matthew Fleischacker. Now it will go back for Polodichuk here. 3:35 to go in overtime off the boards, and this one will be taken a hold of by Wayzata. Carson Peters gave it away at the line, and it's just offsides. Good eye by the official there with 3:26. Crowd starting to give a round of applause to this Wayzata team who's making things interesting. Too many men against Hill Murray, so we're going to get a power play with.
I got a penalty for too many men. Yeah.
Too many men on the ice for the Pioneers.
Yeah, we don't really have a signal for it.
So Wayzata looks like they're going to be going on the power play here with 3:26 to go. So they're discussing with head coach Bill Lechner at the Hill Murray bench, but that is a costly play by Hill Murray, and they're going to have to kill off 2 minutes now with just 3:26 to go on the power play, as looks like Seamus Reagan's going to go to the box here. Looks like Nate Hardy for Hill Murray. So too many men on the ice again for the Pioneers. And Wayzata now has a chance to win it on the power play as Hardy will sit for two. So 3:26 to go in overtime. Power play for the Trojans to try and win the game as Schneider will take the draw. Off the draw. Skirted out of there by Hill Murray as they do a nice job on the clear and on the forecheck as well. Carson Peters will play it here for Wayzata and moved up the boards. Long pass from Wegg, connects on the left side. Here they come into the zone. Schneider holding onto it on that left side and back up to the point. Wayzata has already scored a power play goal today. Wegg dishes off down low. Now back up to the point. O'Connell. Wegg shoots, deflects out of play. Desperation dive from Hill Murray, and they get the whistle. That's a nice job in front there. Looks like Jensen, or rather, that's Tristan Tabakul, the forward for Hill Murray. 2:50 to go in this overtime. 1:24 remaining on the Wayzata power play. They win it back. Held on to over at the point. Now across as they work it. Wag back to the point. Move it over to the side here for O'Connell and back down low. Here's Schneider trying to cut inside. Back to Wag at the point. Wag moves it over for O'Connell. O'Connell back down low for Schneider. Switching it up here. 58 to go. Shot there. Blocked in front. And the Pioneers get it down the ice again. Nick Pierre coming into the corner and going way out to play it is the goaltender. Now Pierre trying to throw it towards the goal, but played back behind the net by Bonello. 42 to go on the Trojan power play. Up and to the left side of the boards. They're offside. Schneider couldn't hold up there. So another faceoff outside the Hill Murray zone. Exactly 2 minutes to play. 34 on the Wayzata power play. And we will see if any of these teams decide to call a timeout here or not in the last few minutes or so. Now taken a hold of by the Trojans as they enter the zone. Mortensen dumps it below the goal line. Flyshacker will send it up the boards, but not out. Good keep at the line. Now move it down low here. Siemens trying to get it on the tape of a teammate here as they'll go back down low. Here's Siemens below the goal line. Dishes it off. Held on to by Lukey. Shoots! Scores! Game winner from Lukey! Wayzata wins it with a power play goal from Ben Lukey.
From 16.
As we'll get a look at this one more time on the replay. Take a look at this one. Lukey with an absolute snipe. And Wayzata wins it by a final score of 4-3. Wow, what a game we had here tonight at the Plymouth Ice Center. And Wayzata knocks off Hill Murray in a phenomenal game. And Wayzata keeps it rolling. They have been one of the hottest teams in all of the state of Minnesota. And they win it tonight by a final score of 4-3. So Ben Lukey with the game winner for the Wayzata Trojans with 1:33 remaining in overtime, a power play goal. And that's your game right there. A great battle by Wayzata. They never led this game until now, which was the game winner. So what a game here at the Plymouth Ice Center. Thanks for tuning in as our buddy David Hill is going to go get a picture of the score sheet quick. But again, thanks for tuning in at Wayzata 4, Hill Murray 3, the final. For our producer Tanner Lalick and our camera person David Hillen, I'm Matt Harrington saying so long from the Plymouth Ice Center. Wayzata beats Hill Murray 4-3.